again, guys. So,
hey y'all, welcome back to our channel, Leek Family Farm. So today, I am going to show you how to call our cows. They were way back on the back of our chicken house, and you could see them that they were so excited when they hear my voice. So just watch and relax, and thank you for watching.
Oh no, not he, she's running. Come on! They come. Come on. Oh my goodness. Come on. Suck. They're coming. There's more in the back. More in the back. And I need to go back to the chicken house so that I can work more over there. I'm gonna leave them alone. I have to go back to the chicken house because audit is coming on Monday. So there's more in the back of the chicken house. You could hear them making a sound. Come on, cows! Come on! Come on! I don't know if I say it right, but my husband is he's more professional calling cows than me, but our cows knows me already. Come on! That one is limping. That cow looks pregnant. Come on! Okay guys, I think I need to move because they're standing over there. There's more coming, but I have to go to the chicken house and finish my work over there. So see you guys next time.
Afternoon folks, welcome to Lee Family Farms. We haven't had much time to deer hunt this year. I spent all the deer season in Alabama on a fire detail down there. I left the second day of season. I came back 2 days after it closed. So we haven't had much chance. Our antlerless season's open right now. And yesterday evening, I was able to go down on the other end of the place and kill a doe. And we can kill two here in Oklahoma. So anyway, I was getting ready to feed hay a while ago, and this holler here is where I sight my rifle in at, check them, and way up through there, I saw an ear flicker. I know that's hard to believe, but anyway, I jumped in our gator and started to leave to go feed the cows, and I seen that ear, so I went in, I got my stuff and got my rifle. Slipped up through there a little ways, got a rest on a tree and just watched, and sure enough, they was deer up there quite a ways, and I took a shot. And I'm pretty sure I got it. Matter of fact, I'm so sure that I don't even have a rifle, so let's go see what we can find.
Yeah. That's a big doe. This is behind our house, guys. Uh-oh. Huh, what happened? Is it broken?
This doe has a...
Oh! No, that doe has an oaten. Oh, it's a...
Oh, look.
Oh, he lost it.
A long time ago, look.
He lost his horn.
Yeah, huh? I'll be. Well, that's weird. It is antlerless, and you can tell that the horn has been off for a little while. I mean, it's not. It's a little bloody there where I
knocked. I bet he was a big horn, huh?
Nah, no, not you know, not that big, but he's young, pretty young deer.
He's probably 2 year old. But he's a little high. Anyway, huh? Well, we got
meat. Okay. Gotta figure out how to get it out here.
This is behind our house, guys. It's wood.
A wood. There's I don't know. About 6,000 acres back here behind us. There's not really that many deer. There are a lot of deer, But there's so much land, and it's all like this. And a lot of it's been logged. There's not a lot of oak trees. There is marine. But so in years where there's no acorns, we see lots of deer. This year, there was lots of acorns, and we haven't seen any deer until we started seeing a few deer in the last week. Another reason is the hogs. We trapped a lot of hogs, seen a lot of hogs. And they move around a lot, they eat a lot everywhere they move. So they kind of keep the deer run out sometimes too. But anyway, well, so the only thing we got left is we can bow hunt maybe, if we have time. But we're done gun hunting for the year. We can maybe crossbow. I think we've still got, I'll have to look. Maybe till the 1st of February. I'll have to make sure. They changed that last few years. I'm not going to hunt a whole lot longer though, because the does are going to start, you know, getting where the little ones are in them. And, you know, but.
Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoy it. And please don't forget to subscribe our channel and share. Goodbye. God bless us all.